So, of course, the big story that everybody's talking about right now, President Trump has signed an executive order involving social media companies such as Facebook and Twitter. The president says they are stifling conservative voices. Sam, what is going on?
With me freezing every couple seconds, or are we still talking about Twitter?
I was going to talk about Twitter, but I was going to bail because I was all blurry and frozen, and I figured it would be easier while the internet calmed down in my house.
I'm freezing too. Twitter applied a fact check to two of President Trump's tweets about unsubstantiated claims of fraud with mail-in voting. A warning prompted readers to fact check the post. The president accused Twitter of violating his free speech and interfering in the 2020 election. Press Secretary Kayleigh McEnany says the White House is looking at altering Section 230 of the Communications Decency Act. It shields websites of liability from content created by its users. So is President Trump trying to shut down Twitter? Andy, no, not really.
Well, does he want to? Perhaps.
Probably.
The order probably won't stand. More about that in a second. But first, here's some more background on what the order aims to do. He wants to get rid of the protection Facebook and Twitter have from the content that users post. And a lot of people on both sides of the aisle don't really like Section 230, which is what this is focused on. It's an older piece of legislation. But what does that mean right now? Not much. As we noted earlier, the proposal has a bunch of legal issues. One senator from Oregon called it plainly illegal. Axios reports, President Trump says this order will probably draw a lawsuit. Finally, though, on the topic of free speech, of course, applies to the government, not private companies like Twitter. But critics have pointed out some irony here. If a government censored a private entity, that is in itself a violation of free speech. So a lot of people obviously talking about this on these websites. We, of course, rely on them every single day. Those algorithms are so important for what information comes across. And obviously, we want it to be as fair as possible. If you look at people on the left, they say the conservatives benefit hugely from a lot of the political apparatus that have figured out how to use Twitter and Facebook to push their message. The other side says the exact same thing about the other side. So, the bigger question, of course, is what does this mean? And is this going to change anything right now? The question is probably not right now. As we were saying, there's a lot of issues that probably would be unilaterally very difficult for this to actually mean anything. But something that was interesting that some of the people who I was talking to a little bit earlier were saying, like, okay, is he going to really shut down Twitter? Does he think he can get away with this? And I think the answer is probably no. To me, it feels very much like politics as usual, but like a political move that I think he probably knows it's not going to stand, but it's something that is maybe a response to what happened the past couple of days, probably. And at least just is something that says, look, I'm not going to be censored or no one's going to try to remove my tweets or anything like that. So I don't know. Very interesting. But like Robert is saying, or like you can tell right now, so many pixels, bad frame rate. I'm going to call back in. And Sam, why don't you pick up the show?
Sam,
I'm fine. She actually everything's fine.
Yeah.
We're great. Everything is fine.
All right, call him back in.
All righty, dude.
My little coffee mug. But you know what? It's not just Andy, though. It's me. I think it's the whole system, Robert. We can't seem to get it going smoothly today.
No.
But I guess we'll try.
What's up?
Yes, Jack Dorsey labeled the tweets and as a fact-checking social media company, an arbiter of truth. There you see Jack talking about it. He says his intention is to connect the dots of conflicting statements and show the information in dispute so people can judge for themselves. More transparency from us is critical so folks can clearly see why behind our actions. End quote.